and to strengthen us. This morning we open our hearts to receive your word with meekness and gladness. Thank you so much because your light is shining in our hearts. Thank you so much because the entrance of your word brings light and gives understanding to the simple. We worship you only once again for this grace. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Son of the living God, the people shouted, Amen. Thank you. Good morning, Pastor Kenny. It's good to see you here today. It is a joy to gather like this. I always get reminded with the word of God, which says it's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by the Spirit of the Lord. Congratulations that you are here today. Hallelujah. Well, it has been long since I stood before you to minister the word of God. Got so many things to say, but we will say some of these things in future. I'm going to share with you something very important. You know, God's word can be relied upon. And God has given us his word so that we can know what to do about the things of this life. Which means God's word is not just for us to hear, but for us to live by. And when you get to know the word of God, you can be sure that whatever I'll be involved in, I'm going to succeed. Because you cannot fail with the word of God. You can be sure of victory. You can be sure that I'm going to succeed. You can be sure that I'm going to live a victorious life. Because of the word of God. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
So I would ask you, if you have the Bible, I expect you to come with the Bible, the notebook, and the pen.
As usual.
The book of 2 Timothy.
Timothy,
the third chapter.
Chapter 3.
From verse 14 to 17.
14 to 17.
I'm going to give you a very simple message, which I have titled Understanding What Is Written. And this is so important. The Bible says, are you there? 2 Timothy chapter number 3 verse 14 to 17.
Timothy, watch me, chapter 3, 14 to 17.
But as for you, continue in what you have learned and have firmly believed, knowing from whom you learned it, and how from childhood you have been acquainted with the sacred writings. You have been acquainted with the holy scriptures. I like this. Because Paul is speaking to Timothy. A young man. A young minister. He tells him that you are acquainted with the holy scriptures. Meaning the set apart writings. There are so many writings in this world, written by different men. But the Bible calls these writings as holy scriptures. Meaning writings set apart to be used in the things of God. Writings to be used in the temple. And look at what he says. He says these scriptures are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. In other words, Timothy, who was so skilled scriptures. That he could explain the subject of salvation from the scriptures. I've come to understand this. Listen to this. A man
Umuntu.
Who cannot explain the subject of salvation. Listen to me.
Umfeni.
That man cannot be trusted when it comes to other subjects. Because this is the core of the scriptures. This is the most important subject. So he says, the scriptures are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. Then he says, all scripture is pressed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness. The scriptures are for teaching. And as you are teaching, you got to rebuke. And as you are teaching, you are supposed to correct or to strengthen things. And they are also for education. In other words, we have to pay attention to scriptures. We have to pay attention to the details in the Bible. That the man of God may be thoroughly equipped, may be complete and thoroughly equipped for every good work. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Now, we are talking about understanding what is written. And in this context, we are talking about the scriptures. Many believers have not paid attention to what is written in the Bible, including some ministers. When you listen to them, when you hear their questions, you just conclude that they do not know what is written. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Understanding the scriptures is for your benefit. You cannot be a successful Christian. You cannot be a minister with impact without understanding what is written. It is difficult for a believer to live the life that God has called us to. Listen to this. Without understanding the scriptures. I don't like meetings.
And you call that church service. This time I've come to see some believers. When you say, let us turn to this book, they get tired. They are used to one text and then you begin to fly. But I want you to understand. All our preachings
must come from the scriptures. If they are not coming from the scriptures, then we are doing something different. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Let's do this. Luke 24.
Verse 15 to 27.
The Bible says, while they were talking and discussing together, Jesus himself drew near and went with them. This is after he had been raised from the dead. Cleopas and a friend, they were going to Emmaus. And as they were going, they started discussing the events that took place, which many people around the world are trying to observe. As they were discussing, the Bible tells us Jesus joined them. Watch what happened. Jesus drew near himself and went with them, but their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to him, what conversation that you are holding with each other as you walk? And they stood still looking sad. Then one of them named Cleopas answered him, are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know the things that have happened there in these days? Now listen to this. Any preacher who says I preach the gospel must know how to explain the gospel using the events. The events that took place, that's where we get the explanation of the gospel. Jesus suffered. Jesus was buried. Jesus resurrected. So you use the events to explain the gospel. So they were discussing. See, Jesus asked him. Now can you imagine? Listen, please pay attention. How can they ask the man they had seen before? They walked with him. They saw him doing miracles. But after resurrection, they could not recognize him. Why? I remember sharing with you some time back. The God does not want us to know Jesus through visions. He doesn't want us to know Jesus by physical contact. No, he wants us to know Jesus through the scriptures. A man who knows Jesus through the scriptures doesn't know him. No, you do not know him. If you are going to know him, it must be through the scriptures. The scriptures reveal him to us. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Look at this. And he said to them, what things? And he said to him, concerning Jesus of Nazareth. Now I've told you about this. Jesus of Nazareth is seen in the four Gospels. In the Epistles, he is not Jesus of Nazareth. No. He is Christ the Lord, the exalted one. Hallelujah. To know Jesus as Jesus of Nazareth is to know him according to the flesh. Hallelujah. So the Bible says, concerning Jesus of Nazareth, the man who was a prophet, might indeed and will it before God and all the people. And our chief priests and rulers delivered him up to be condemned to death. Can you imagine? Look at this. Listen. The priests and rulers. The priests who are studying the scriptures did not know Jesus. And when he came, they stood against him. That's why I hate religion. Because religion blinds people from seeing the reality. The priests were supposed to support Jesus, but they were the ones who delivered him to death. What a shame. It has not changed. In our time, in the times to come, religious men will always arise and stand against the gospel. But thank God, the gospel was more. That's why you have come to understand. If you want to be on the winning side, be on the side of the gospel. When you are on the side of the gospel, you are on the side of Christ. When you are on the religious men condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes.
Yeah.
And beside all this, it is now the third day since these things happened. Some women of our company missed us. They went to the tomb, at the tomb, early in the morning. And when they did not find his body, they came back saying that they had even seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Now look at these men. They walked with Jesus. They were always in the synagogue learning about Christ, but they never understood what was
happening.
That's why when the women gave them the report,
they
did not find his body. They did not believe. They were amazed. Why? Because they did not understand that which was written. If they understood the writings of Moses, if they had understood the writings of the prophets, they could have not been amazed. They could have believed. That's why I'm calling you, every one of us here, to understand what is written for us in the scriptures. Do you know that today, almost all over the world, people are preaching about Christ? That's what they are focusing on. After today, they go back to preach other things. That is where the problem is. Hallelujah. Somebody said last week, I don't even find one of us. He says, so you are not observing Easter. I said to him, we don't observe Easter. Actually, if you are a good student of the word of God, in the Bible, the word Easter is not there. Understand. It's not there. And again I said, we don't observe this. The Jewish people are observing the days. We observe the man.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We don't wait for this. We are this man with us always. He is in us and we are in here. So we don't observe the days. That's what the Bible tells us. We look unto Jesus. He says we see Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'm not hearing you. Hallelujah. We observe a man.
But
then the Bible says, some of us who are with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said. But him they did not see. Now look at Jesus. And he said to them, O foolish ones and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Who is he talking to? The disciples. Slow of heart to believe. Listen to this. Everything the prophet said about Christ was not for the audience to do, was for the audience to believe. They were to believe. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory? And
begin
with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them in all the scriptures things concerning himself. Now look. This is what I've said always. Jesus,
yes,
when he went to the writings,
yes,
of Moses,
yes,
the writings of the prophets,
yes,
he did not interpret everything. No,
yes,
that is the problem I've seen with many people.
Yes,
when they are studying the Bible,
yes,
they want to interpret things which do not concern them.
Yes,
Jesus,
yes,
interpreted things,
yes,
which concerned him.
Yes,
so what ever did not concern him in the writings, he left them. He didn't interpret it. So what am I talking about today? I want you to understand, a believer can easily be deceived if he does not understand what is written. Anybody can tell you, including me,
I know in a few.
I can tell you something. In the service like this one. But you have to ask yourself, is this thing written? If I say it, Don't believe it just because it's new saying. No. That is ignorance. And that is nonsense. Don't listen, don't accept it. Until you confirm with what is written. In other words, you must come to a place where if I say something that is contrary, you can say, no, this is not right. And I believe that is a good minister. A good minister must teach the people to the point that when he errs, they can go to the scripture and say, you are not correct here, sir or mother. I'm not scared.
She
I have to tell you the truth. Hallelujah. The time of ignorance is over. We are not going to allow ignorance to
exist.
No. We are taking this gospel around the world. We are just beginning. I'm telling you, this is just the beginning. We are taking it over. Hallelujah. This is the beginning of a revolution. The gospel revolution is going around this nation by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Praise the Lord.
Understand what is written. Now listen to this. Let me show something. John chapter number 20. I'm going to read verse 30 to 31. Please pay attention. You see how you can use what is written to help the sinners. And use what is written to help yourself and others. I remember I was telling somebody that you see, Bambi Mamuna took Smikla Gula and the Fiat. Banga Bambus Mat. Mwema na makwales. Mwema ntu. Ala tulie pepa. Ino chita na chupa. Tufuyo kula longa na bonsi. Ala chelo na chacha. Tulie pepa leo choyu. Ewa tuumbe. You think you are preaching. You are joking. That's not preaching.
Ukote kushimikira kwa mga luku.
Hello? Are you there in John? Now Jesus parted.
Yes,
did many other signs in the presence of the disciples. Listen to this first of all. A sign is like a symbol pointing to something. Which means, now listen carefully. Every miracle Jesus did was pointing to himself and the
faithful.
Every miracle, I want to understand. When he opened the blind eyes, it was pointing to himself as a
working
God. When he raised the dead, it was pointing to his work. So every miracle Jesus did,
yes,
was pointing to himself and his
God.
Too much. Hallelujah.
Oh yes.
So he did so many signs in the presence of the disciples, which are not written in the book. Now look at this next one. 31. But these are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name. So look at this. He says, these are written. We are talking about understanding what is written. These are written that you may believe. And that believing you may have eternal life. Pay attention. He sent this to a sinner. This is a message. A sinner. A believer is not going to believe. He's already a believer. Hello?
Praise the Lord.
It is for a sinner to believe, not for a believer to believe. We have already believed. I don't need to believe. The faith I have is enough. Some people say, no, you have to believe. Believe. You are preaching to a believer to believe. What are you trying to achieve? I'm a believer. Now, if the faith I received through the gospel brought eternal life in me. You know what it means? I have all things now. So he says, pay attention. These are written that you may believe. Always understand the audience. You may believe there is not referring to believers. It's referring to the sinner. That's why he says that when you believe, you may have eternal life. You may have life through his name. A believer has believed. A believer has eternal life. You are not going to have eternal life. Like I always say, eternal life is not life after death. It's not life after death. Okay. Have you gotten the point? Hello?
Yes, sir.
The sinner believes to have. To have what? Eternal life. Amen?
Amen.
But listen. He has to believe what is written. Okay, beautiful. Let's go to a believer who has already believed. 1 John chapter number 5,
chapter 5,
verse 13.
Verse 13.
Get there, please.
Na,
so a sinner goes to what is written.
Ale,
he understands it.
Ale,
listen to me.
Mfwin.
Then he receives life.
Ale,
he's not supposed to do something.
He's
not supposed to pray.
He's
not supposed to confess.
He's
not supposed to do any other thing or to fast.
He is
supposed to believe. That's what the Bible says. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have. So we believe to have. Okay.